There's always a I never know with Trump. Well, there's a method to a lot of the madness. And when you see, you know, anybody that harbored any sort of sentimental feelings about Ted Cruz, oh, he didn't quite make it, maybe he'll be around in 2020. After that last night, I mean, you look, you know, Drudge doesn't shape all the opinion, but if you do look at what Drudge said, he said this guy is in Republican hell now. So I don't know.
Yeah, I think he went in there with a plan to wreck it. That's exactly what he did. I think it backfired on him. I think it maybe in the short term, he thinks it's going to be, look, I've already got an email solicitation for him to continue on the fight and ask for money. The group knew exactly what they were doing. But I think long term, this is a loser for Ted Cruz. He came across as absolutely selfish. He came across, this is all about me. And quite frankly, this is a person that lost. And in our world, in our country, we were taught that you could be a good loser. And sometimes if you want to know the character of somebody, it's not about how they act when they win, it's about how they act when they lose. And he certainly showed his character last night.
In a Pavlovian sense, I thought he would have been penalized with some of the stunts he pulled as a first-term senator, the filibustering and the, right. You know, Mr. Smith goes to Washington and closing down the government. And people said it was all about him, but then he almost won the nomination. So he wasn't... I think he thought that it worked for him, like the dog, you know, you press and you get whatever, you know, you get some food. But I think it backfired last night. I think he went back to the well one too many times with the selfish, you know, Ted Cruz-centric speech.
Absolutely. I couldn't agree more. And I mean, even go to his afternoon speech to his supporters sounded like a mini Ted Cruz convention, not at all about the nominee or Donald Trump or about the party. It was about Ted Cruz.
Till the plane with the gold letters.
Now, that was good TV.
But you don't think he won the game? Meaning, this is the piece that I'm unclear about. You could be frustrated with him depending on which side of the aisle you are on or even within the aisle you're on. But ultimately, didn't he win by doing what he did, the fact that we're talking about it and how ultimately people are going to start thinking or questioning what's going on? No?
Well, so look, short term, I'm sure he thinks he's going to win. I've talked to several people last night. Obviously, it hadn't been that long in between. I expect a lot more phone calls and emails this morning. People that lean towards Ted Cruz, that supported him in the primary, that are furious with him right now. They all say, this is Donald Trump may not have been my first or second choice, but he's the only option we have to stop Hillary Clinton. This might as well have been a campaign speech that Ted Cruz gave next week at the Democrat convention, because this did more to help Hillary Clinton be elected president than it did to help Ted Cruz in the long term.
But that was his goal.
That was his goal. But what I'm saying is people that were probably could lean to support Ted Cruz or could get behind Ted Cruz, they're not going to do that, even if the seats open in 2020.
Running. Yeah, but
I'm saying if it goes for 2020. And like I said, he set the precedent now. So let's fast forward. Let's say something happens. Donald Trump's not the president of the United States. Ted Cruz is the nominee in 2020. He just gave free license to anybody to skip the convention or come to the convention and give a speech
but
and not endorse
him. But I think he miscalculated.
Absolutely.
I think he might have miscalculated. I don't think he was expecting boos at the end. Mike, back to who's meaner to whom. Lock her up, okay, I understand that, but, you know, after Comey. But the words associated so far with Trump, seriously, fascist, racist, misogynist. I get stuff that says Orange Hitler is what I see, what people write it. And even on a supposed journalistic website, every single time the Huffington Post mentions Trump, they call him a serial liar, a rampant xenophobe, a racist, misogynist, and birther. Yeah. Is it possible that the Republicans have gone over the top on Hillary Clinton when this has been the last 6 months on Donald Trump?
Again, I go back to what makes good political strategy. Those people are talking to themselves. When they're chanting to lock her up, those people are talking to themselves. In the end, there are a group of people out there. There may not be many of them.
What do you think, 10, 15%?
Could be.
Because it's 40-40.
They're going to be decisive in this election. Ultimately, that's who these conventions are supposed to appeal to and talk to. And I don't think that this has been successful for them in terms of reaching outside of the hall. If you stop, just right now, we're on day 4 of the convention. We spent the first 2 days talking about plagiarism. This morning we're talking about, you know, internecine warfare in the Republican Party. This is about ball control. In the modern day, conventions are the only real estate you have.
Yeah, but when they go well, you get a the Kerry convention, oh, my God, he came and said, I'm ready for service. These things were all scripted, and they all went well. It didn't work for Kerry. Didn't work for Romney.
But a lot of them went well for the winner, and usually they were there filling out their bio, right, talking
about
their agenda.
So it should be bored, and no one should.
Like I said, good television. I've been tuning in. It's fascinating to me. I'm not sure it's doing what they intended it to do.
But Trump has always been good television, and Trump has ultimately done as well as he had because it's been unconventional.
He won a very divided Republican primary on that strategy. I don't know if he can win the general election by continuing
Nobody
to rely
does.
On that.
Nobody does, but then we got crazy stuff, Brexit. We got crazy underpinnings that, you know, people keep. Suddenly, Buffalo Springfield, everybody knows the band now because that song is so, there's something happening here.
Yeah. There hasn't been a lot of discussion about Brexit at the Republican
convention. I'm not saying it has to do with Brexit. I'm saying that the same thing that's happening, the populist, nationalistic, the move away from globalism.
I agree that there has been, this is a very unsettled time, and people this is a change environment. But I'm not sure the Trump team has taken advantage of that so far.
Do all those people who are screaming Heidi out of there by screaming Goldman Sachs know that Trump wants Steve Mnuchin to be the Treasury Secretary?
They
haven't connected those dots yet?
You think Wall Street guys are good. I mean, you think Wall Street guys are good Treasury Secretaries, don't you?
I have no problem with a Wall Street guy being a Treasury Secretary.
Some of them do know about money.
They might know
Paulson,
something. I'm not.
Robert
you're
Rubin.
Not gonna, yep.
Okay. All right. Last word, Chip, or no?
Well, I mean, look, as we go into the convention, like you said, at best, Donald Trump's done everything unconventional. I think tonight, if between
Except
Ivanka and Donald Trump, I think Governor Pence did a great job last night.
It was a pick that people that were looking for stability. I mean, when you got Paul Ryan saying you couldn't get a better pick.
Yeah, and I think you saw last night he gave a great speech, and there was a lot of good points, and he hit on them. Again, this morning we're talking about Ted Cruz, but I think what you're going to see over the next couple of months is Mike Pence doing a great job is on a lot of different fronts, and some of that is uniting the party.
Yeah. Young Pence is 57. That hair is white.
It's been that way for a long time. It's been like that ever since I've known him.
It's like credibility, something. I may get rid of the Clairol, you know, and just let, what
just
do you
let
think?
Let it go. Let's go
white.
I don't know. Makes me think that maybe, you know, all this effort I go through every, you know, because I don't like, you know, when I have white roots. I don't like that. So,
When they put the system back on, you can talk to them.
It's easy. I can send it out to have it dyed or not dyed. That's the whole thing. It's
talk
sort of
talk to the people.
I don't have to go there. And I have people send it out. Anyway, thanks, Chip.
Thanks. Always great to see you. We got to talk Elon Musk this morning. He